Everyone, welcome to another Sunday and welcome to another topic and welcome to M for Montessori. Today we will be talking about parent and teacher conversations. Please note that next month, that's in March 2020, we will be doing a detailed video or couple of videos actually on parent-teacher conferences or parent-teacher meetings, as they're popularly called, and we will be dealing with in detail with those aspects for both parents and teachers. But this video is more about the softer aspects of how to connect with your child's teacher. I always believe that parents need to work as partners in your child's education journey, more so in preschool, because that is the first experience of your child with formal schoolings. So you need to keep in mind that you and the child's teacher is on the same team. It has to be an approach where both are respected, the parent and the teacher, both are listened to, both are given an opportunity to speak, because in normal circumstances, a teacher is working for the best of your child and you want the best for your child. So you basically, both of you are on the same team. Before I talk about conversations, let me tell you, try and involve yourself in the school or the preschool your child goes through to a certain extent. Now, there are schools which need a lot of involvement and they appreciate it, and there are schools which don't. So if your school does allow parent volunteers or parent coming up and talking to children on various topics, then great. Be a part of that school. That doesn't only make you feel involved, but even your child starts feeling that connection with the school. So whenever you go for a meeting to discuss anything with your child's teacher, make sure you take an appointment. That's very important. Obviously, it's something which should be done, but many a times it happens we forget to take appointments. So please make sure that you do take an appointment, a prior appointment, before going and meeting the teacher, and always try and be on time. Always have your points very clearly mentioned, because that'll save your time. It'll save the teacher's time as well. And be ready, as I always tell, be ready to speak and to listen. That's how a normal conversation should take place. Focus on the area that you need to discuss. It can be a problem, it can be a concern, it can be a good thing, a bad thing, anything. But focus on that. Avoid any kind of blame game or any kind of attacks. And I'm talking for both the parents and teachers. Both should avoid that, because the parent-teacher conversation should be dealt with respectfully, cordially, rather than being, if you're on two opposite sides, nothing will happen. Okay, balance your approach to school when it comes to interactions. Always take an appointment, as I said, but don't expect your child's teacher to be there and report to you every single day. That's a little bit too much. And obviously, when we want you to come, or when a teacher has called you for a special meeting or a PTM, try and take out some time. And I'm talking to both the parents. Both the parents should be involved. It's not the mother's responsibility and or the father's responsibility. If both parents are involved, then both parents should be involved. And try and get involved with schools besides these meetings, in open houses, as I mentioned, become volunteers, or you may also attend sessions. Some schools have educative sessions. We have Super Saturdays, which are some amazing sessions, which are full of some amazing conversation between parents and teachers on beautiful topics. So I'm sure many schools out there are doing that. So if your school is doing that, please make yourself involved, because then your child will feel involved in the school. Remember that you're on the same team. I cannot repeat that enough. Parents as partners, you and your teacher, child's teacher, is on the same boat. Respect, mutual respect is very important. If you will give respect, you'll get respect. And please don't be that parent who every teacher wants to avoid. I know I might be sounding a little harsh, but that was the best way to put it. And I want to put it in front of you. Try and listen and speak. You will be given a chance to talk, but you should listen as well. I would say listening is more than talking, and it's for both parents and teachers. Right? Let's discuss a point. If you want to discuss a problem area or concern area, what then? Describe the situation. In fact, state facts. Have you seen a case where a journalist maybe, or maybe a lawyer, when they narrate something, they are expected to state facts, right? Even in your office, when your junior gives you some reports, or you give some reports to someone, to your boss, then you are expected to make it factual. So if you're discussing a situation or concern, please take points and discuss that with the teacher. And again, I'll say it again, I cannot say it enough, talk and listen. A two-way communication is very important. Without blaming, without attacking. I know I'm repeating these 2 points, but these are very important. Again, be as truthful as possible. Jot down points. For instance, if you're saying your child doesn't listen to you at home, but the teacher is saying that the child is very well behaved here, and discuss that with details. If you're talking that your child has been met with an accident, God forbid, in school, and your teacher doesn't has a clue about it, discuss what your child is telling you. Ask them to give you some kind of CCTV footage or something, which can show you what incident your child wants to narrate, especially with younger children, right? Next month, as I said, we will be discussing more about parent-teacher meetings. So stay tuned. If you have any topic, please let us know. And this was a topic that I really wanted to just speak my heart out, and I think I did. If you liked what you saw, please hit the like button, ring the bell, and share this video so that we reach to more and more parents. Our Facebook and our Instagram handles are below in the comment section. So you can like us or follow us there as well. Have a great Sunday ahead and an amazing week. Till then, bye-bye.